The allure of the supernatural and the unexplained has always fascinated humanity, and among the most compelling manifestations of this curiosity are the stories surrounding haunted buildings. Join me. I'm going to uncover the top 15 most haunted buildings in the world. Starting with number 15, the Forbidden City. Beijing's Forbidden City was China's former imperial palace, and for 600 years it was home to its fair share of poisonings, executions, and betrayals. And while it has been open to the public as a museum since the 1940s, it should come as little surprise that it's been home to a lot of paranormal activity. The most common occurrence involved a woman dressed in white while strolling around the grounds and sobbing. However, stories surrounding screams, clashing swords, and ghostly visions of blood and silk have also been reported. Number 14. Charleville Castle. Located near the village of Tullamore, Charleville Castle was originally built as a holiday residence by the first Earl of Charleville. However, on April 3rd of 1861, a holiday turned into a nightmare when tragedy struck. 7-year-old Lady Harriet Bury was going downstairs when she tried to slide down the banister. This turned fatal when she lost her balance and fell 2 stories down onto the stone floor below. She supposedly now haunts the castle and has been known to bang on doors and sing as she runs through the halls. Ooh, no thanks. Number 13. The Fairmont Banff Springs Hotel. So Banff is one of Canada's most beautiful national parks, and the Fairmont Banff Springs Hotel is one of the area's most luxurious places to stay. Built in 1888 to encourage tourism and sell train tickets, this chateau-style hotel is reportedly home to several resident ghosts. While some, such as the bride who supposedly fell down a stone staircase on her wedding day, are tragic, others, such as Sam, the kind bellman, are more positive. Well, in any case, if you want to mix paranormal activity with beautiful natural adventures, a trip here is well worth it. Number 12. The Eastern State Penitentiary. In 1829, Eastern State Penitentiary in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, attempted to reform the prison system. On the surface, it seemed like paradise. After all, prisoners were given near unlimited food alongside private bathrooms and private exercise facilities. However, they were given absolutely zero human interaction, and this drove many of the prisoners mad. Eventually, the prison reverted to a more standard system, and soon horrible forms of punishment and overcrowding became the norm. Now, thankfully, over 100 years of operation, it closed for good in 1970. However, ever since, it's seen thousands of visitors every year and has experienced paranormal occurrences such as disembodied laughter, shadowy figures, and pacing footsteps. Number 11. Casa Loma. Known for being one of Toronto's most stately historic homes, the Gothic-style Casa Loma Mansion is a famous haunted house. Completed in 1914 for the modern equivalent of about $110 million, it was the home of wealthy financier Sir Henry Pallott and his wife Mary before financial difficulties forced them to move out. Yet despite this untimely eviction, the couple and their servants are still seen on the ground to this day. These include the White Lady, who died of influenza in the early 1900s and is often spotted cleaning up at the cafeteria at the end of a shift. Mary Pallott, who often tampers with tapes and cameras when placed in her bedroom, and Sir Henry himself, who roams around the premises. Number 10. The Halcyon House. Now, while the Halcyon House may just look like any other stately mansion in Georgetown, it hides its fair share of paranormal activities. Just a block away from the high-end boutiques that line Georgetown's famed M Street, the home in question was built in 1787 by Benjamin Stoddart. As America's first Secretary of the Navy and a pallbearer at George Washington's funeral, he was an important figure in the early days of the Republic, although over the years, the house has changed ownership multiple times. One of the most famous of these homeowners was Mark Twain's nephew, Albert Clemens. He purchased the home from Benjamin Stoddart's daughter in 1900, and for unexplained reasons, believed that if he perpetually rebuilt the house, this would extend his life. It was because of this belief that he got to work making a dizzying array of bizarre changes, including the construction of staircases that led nowhere, the installation of an assortment of secret trap doors, and the building of tiny rooms that served no real purpose. Well, in any case, the 21,000-square-foot home is now owned by a Japanese philanthropist who uses it as a headquarters of a nonprofit science, art, and entrepreneurial startup incubator named Halcyon. Yet despite now being a rather forward-thinking place, the home is believed to still be haunted by Benjamin Stoddart, Albert Clemens, and the spirits of a group of runaway slaves that perished in the building's basement after escaping from the South, and a mysterious unknown woman who can sometimes be seen through an upstairs window. However, if you're interested in seeing these ghosts for yourself, you may have some difficulty. After all, you'll have to get in with the Halcyon Corporation as either a fellow in their incubator or as a sponsor holding an event in order to enter the premises. Number 9. Edinburgh Castle. So a trip to Edinburgh is incomplete without a visit to Edinburgh Castle. It dominates the city skyline. Its origins date all the way back to the 12th century. Now, due to its important strategic location, it's been an important fortress in several Scottish battles, with some of the most prominent being the Wars of Scottish Independence in the 14th century and the Jacobite Uprising of 1745. In fact, these battles were so frequent that the castle reportedly underwent 26 sieges in its roughly 1,000-year history, making it one of the most attacked fortresses in the entire world. As such, it shouldn't come as a surprise that quite a few spirits haunt the premises. One of the most famous is that of a young piper. The story goes that a few hundred years ago, some tunnels were found below the castle. This piqued the curiosity of the young bagpiper, who decided to explore them. Now, in order to let people above ground hear where he was, he brought his bagpipes. However, after he got about halfway, the music stopped, and when rescuers were sent to find him, he had reportedly vanished without a trace. Yet while his physical body may be missing, his spirit stuck around, as the music from his bagpipes can still be heard wafting through the tunnels to this very day. Beyond the piper, though, the castle is also haunted by many military men. One of the most notable of these is a headless drummer boy, who supposedly began making appearances in 1650. While not much is known about him, his drumming is often heard from the battlements, and apparently the sight of him is also a forewarning of danger was about to come upon the castle. To top this off, the castle's dungeons were also known to be spiritually active, as they're home to the souls of many an English soldier who was captured in the battle. So, if you'd like to see some paranormal activity in Scotland, you can't go wrong booking a tour at Edinburgh Castle. Number 8. Scott Bagan's Haunted Museum. When you book a trip to Las Vegas in Nevada, chances are that opulent casinos, incredible shows, and top-tier restaurants are on your radar. However, one attraction that's a bit off the beaten path that's worth checking out is Zach Bagan's Haunted Museum. You see, in 2017, Zach Bagans, who is the host of the popular Travel Channel's Ghost Adventures, opened this haunted museum in one of Las Vegas' oldest residences. Constructed in 1938 as a mansion for banker Cyril Wegner, the property most recently housed the Nevada Bar Association. However, it seems to also have housed some paranormal activity. After all, it's said that the Cyril family's members still haunt this home, and in the 1970s, satanic rituals are said to have taken place in the basement. While it's impossible to verify these claims, what is clear is that the home has now been filled with more than its fair share of unsettling artifacts. For example, one room features memorabilia related to famous serial killers such as Charles Manson, John Wayne Gacy, and Richard Ramirez. Another allows visitors to peek inside Dr. Kevorkian's Volkswagen death van. In fact, there's even an exhibit featuring objects previously owned by former Las Vegas residents and entertainers such as Michael Jackson and Liberace. While these macabre objects are strange enough, what's even worse are the exhibits that show haunted artifacts. For example, there's the infamous doll Peggy, who is said to have caused serious illness over 80 innocent people, and the original staircase from the Indiana Demon House, which was notorious for its powerful paranormal activity. In any case, if you'd like to visit, you'll have to meet certain requirements. After all, children under the age of 16 are not permitted, and guests under 18 are not allowed in certain exhibits. And you've got to sign a waiver before entering and be prepared for multiple jump scares and large graphic photos. However, so long as you're not easily frightened, a trip to this incredible haunted building can be quite enjoyable. Moving on to number 7, Kelly's Castle. So when you think of Malaysia, lush rainforests and bustling cities are probably what comes to mind. However, it turns out that the country is also home to a very eerie haunted house. It's known as Kelly's Castle. It was once the property of a certain William Kelly Smith. He was a civil engineer who traveled to Malaysia with dreams of making it rich. And while he went through years upon years of failed businesses, he eventually became very wealthy thanks to his investments. This incited him to build a massive mansion for his family, with the idea being it would be the largest building in all of Malaysia. His hope was to pick up his family in Scotland and bring them over. However, these plans got cut short when William died of pneumonia while purchasing an elevator in the Portuguese capital of Lisbon. In response, his family simply sold the uncompleted home and remained in Scotland. The owners who received Kelly's construction project never bothered to finish the home, and to this day the castle remains uncompleted. However, the castle's lack of completion has not led to a lack of paranormal activity. There have been multiple reports of ghostly figures being spotted through the windows, and some even claim to have seen William's daughter in the bedroom. However, given that they died thousands of kilometers away, many don't believe that the ghosts of the Kellys can be found there. Instead, most point the finger at the Tamil workers who died of Spanish flu during the building's construction. There are even strange reports that there are at least three secret tunnels on the premises, with eyewitnesses claiming that a car was parked inside one passageway in the 1960s. However, no solid proof of this has ever been found. Well, regardless, I think it's fair to say that Kelly Castle is nothing if not ominous. Number 6. The Demon House. Few things are as scary as the prospect of having demons in your house, yet that's exactly what seemed to be the case for Latoya Ammons, her mother, and her three children. Located in Gary, Indiana, the home was moved into by the family in November of 2011, and it wasn't long before paranormal activity began to happen. Just a few days after moving in, they claimed the black flies swarmed the porch and would keep returning even after the family took measures to kill them off. Given the fact that this happened outside, this could be explained away as just an unfortunate external reality. However, what wasn't so understandable were the creaking doors and unexplained footsteps they'd hear in the basement. Soon, things began to escalate, with Latoya claiming to have witnessed a shadowy figure of a man pacing in the living room and finding an unexplained boot print in the home. Meanwhile, Latoya's mother claimed she was occasionally choked by an unknown force, yet all of this paled in comparison to what happened to the kids. For example, Latoya's 12-year-old daughter apparently levitated above the bed, unconscious during a sleepover, only returning to the bed after her friends began praying. Even worse, Latoya's youngest son was allegedly possessed by an unknown force, with his eyes rolling to the back of his head as he growled, saying, "It's time to die and I will kill you." In May of 2012, the family decided to move to Indianapolis. After doing so, their paranormal encounters stopped. After being publicized in January of 2014, the story gained national attention. It was probably because of this attention that Zach Bagans, who was host and executive producer of the show Ghost Adventures, promptly purchased the home and got to work creating a documentary. Once the filming was complete, he rid his hands of the place, and in 2016, the so-called Demon House was demolished. Unsurprisingly, these stories garnered quite a bit of skepticism, with some experts from agencies such as the Department of Child Services believing that the children were simply performing for their mother. However, others, such as 37-year-old police captain Charles Austin, who conducted the investigation, and Father Michael Maginot, who performed three exorcisms on the house, all tell a different tale. From seeing dark and shadowy figures to feeling the presence of demons, they all seemed to think the house was far from normal. However, the reality is that as much as we may speculate, we'll never know for certain what went on between those four walls. Number 5. Chillingham Castle. If you're scared of ghosts, then chances are that you'll get chills at Chillingham Castle. It's located in the North English county of Northumberland. It was originally built in the late 12th century as a monastery. However, its proximity to the border between England and Scotland caused it to be converted into a castle, and it served as a staging ground for several English and Scottish invasions. Yet once wars between the two nations ceased, the castle was converted into a more elegant abode, and it now serves as a stately hotel. While it may seem like a lovely place to stay the night, I'd suggest looking elsewhere. That's because it's reportedly one of the most haunted castles in England, and for good reason. Home to a host of different spirits, guests have reported all sorts of strange activity in the hotel, yet there are spirits that stand out in particular. First is the Radiant Boy, a young boy generally seen in the Pink Room. His claim to fame is his shrieks of either fear or pain at the stroke of midnight. In the past, cries always seemed to come from a specific spot in the wall, and once the shrieks faded, a figure of a young boy dressed in blue would appear. Eventually, the owners became curious and decided to open up this section of the wall. To their shock, they found the bones of a child surrounded by decaying fragments of blue cloth. After being given a Christian burial, the Radiant Boy apparently disappeared for quite some time. However, once guests began to sleep in the room, blue flashes of light began to appear, signaling that his spirit had continued to linger. The second famous ghost at Chillingham was the spirit of Lady Berkeley, the wife of a certain Lord Grey. She was left abandoned with their baby daughter when her husband ran off with her own sister. To this day, she can still be heard calling for her husband in the corridors, leaving a cold chill wherever she goes. A third and final major spirit is the so-called White Pantry Ghost. The story goes that a cache of silver was stored here, and a footman was locked inside at night in order to guard it. Yet one fateful evening, he was approached by a wispy white lady who asked him for a drink of water. When he poured the water for her and turned back to give it to her, she had vanished. Ever since, her pale figure has been visible in the room from time to time. Number 4. Hoska Castle. Most medieval castles were made to serve as military forts, houses of the nobility, or a combination of the two. However, Hoska Castle is a bit different. It's located about 47 kilometers north of the Czech capital of Prague. King Ottokar II of Bohemia had the Gothic structure built there sometime between 1253 and 1278, and it stands apart due to it reportedly being made to house demons. While this may sound ridiculous at first, the evidence in favor of this conclusion is surprisingly concrete. You see, unlike most castles, Hoska Castle was built in a remote area filled with forests, swamps, and mountains. This placement was far from all known trade routes, making its location seemingly pointless. If that wasn't weird enough, it almost has no external fortifications, no source of water except for a small cistern to collect rainwater, no kitchen, and at the time of completion, no occupants. In fact, the original construction was so odd that it omitted stairs from the courtyard to the upper floors and had most of the structural defenses built facing inwards. Looked at objectively, it was almost as if the purpose of the castle wasn't to keep invaders out, but rather to keep something trapped within. And trap it did. Home to a supposedly bottomless pit known as the Gateway to Hell, the castle may have been made to keep this hole in check. According to some reports, beasts used to emerge from hiding in the hole and terrify local villagers. In response, the king sealed it off with stone plates and built a chapel dedicated to the Archangel Michael on top of it. This dedication is quite significant. After all, it was Michael who, according to the Bible, led God's armies against Lucifer's fallen angels. So the idea behind it was probably to use the power of God to defeat the devil. In any case, despite its supposedly demonic duties, the castle has had a few occupants. For example, in 1639, it was allegedly occupied by a Swedish mercenary named Oronto, who worked on black magic in the attempt to create an elixir for eternal life. It was also fully restored in 1823, and then in the 1870s purchased by Joseph Szymanek, who was the president of a famous auto company, Skoda. In the 1940s, things took a turn for the worse when the Nazis occupied it, and allegedly they used the place to conduct occult experiments. Now, it should be noted that some of the history surrounding the castle is a bit sketchy. After all, scholars have since discovered cracks in its history, and the evidence of the Swedish mercenary Oronto's existence is rather dubious. Yet despite there being some inconsistencies, what is clear is that Hoska Castle is a pretty spooky place. Number 2. King Tut's Tomb. Of all the Egyptian tombs in the Valley of the Kings, few are quite as famous as that of the boy King Tut. The story goes that in 1891, a man by the name of Howard Carter arrived in Egypt. By the time of his arrival, most of the tombs of the Egyptian pharaohs had been found, although one remained elusive, the tomb of King Tut. After the end of World War I, Carter made it his mission to find the tomb. After years of work, on November 4, 1923, he found the steps to the burial room hidden in the debris near the entrance of the nearby tomb of King Ramses VI. A few weeks later, Carter and fellow archaeologist and benefactor Lord Carnarvon ventured inside, and what they found was nothing short of incredible. The luxurious four-room tomb consisted of more than 5,000 objects, the most famous of which was the sarcophagus of King Tut, which is more than 3,000 years old and made of solid gold. Finding the tomb not only provided a wealth of insight into the material culture of the wealthy ancient Egyptians, but it also led to a media frenzy that popularized ancient Egyptian-inspired designs to the Western public. Perhaps more importantly, it also gave the newly independent state of Egypt a sense of national pride, with the discovery being considered to be a major victory, given that most of the artifacts were brought back not to London, but to the Egyptian Museum in Cairo. Now, there's widespread speculation that King Tut still haunts this tomb, and he's laid a powerful curse on all those who disturb his final resting place. This is because many of the archaeologists who discovered the tomb suffered strange and unusual deaths soon after its discovery. The first of these deaths was that of Lord Carnarvon, who was the man who financed the excavation. The story goes that shortly after finding the tomb, he was bitten by a mosquito. He then accidentally slashed the bite while shaving, and it became so badly infected that it resulted in blood poisoning. This blood poisoning ended up leading to his demise. That next year, a certain George J. Gould I, who was a visitor to the tomb, died in the French Riviera after developing a surprise fever. About 5 years after that, A.C. Mace, who was a member of Carter's excavation team, passed away due to pneumonia. And in 1929, excavation secretary Captain Richard Bethel died in a bed in a club. An investigation determined that he was likely the victim of smothering. Now, it should be noted that the evidence is far from conclusive. After all, a study showed that of the 58 people who were present when the tomb and sarcophagus were opened, only 8 died within a dozen years, with some living for decades afterwards. Interestingly enough, there was also no written curse found within the tomb. Therefore, while there may be many theories about the curse of the pharaohs, it's hard to know whether or not it actually exists. Number 1. The Winchester Mystery House. If you travel to San Jose, you can visit a mansion that just may be California's most intriguing haunted house. It's known as the Winchester Mystery House. The property has had relatively humble origins. Back in the mid-1800s, it was a modest 8-room farmhouse in California's Santa Clara Valley. However, after a certain Sarah Winchester inherited the Winchester rifle family fortune from her father-in-law and husband after the passing between 1880 and 1881, she decided that she wanted a change from scenery and the family mansion in New Haven, Connecticut. Based upon both happy memories from her travels and the recommendation of a doctor, she decided to move to California to take advantage of the warm weather. And after searching around, she decided to buy the property that became the Winchester Mystery House. With little to do and a large fortune, Sarah and her 3 sisters got to work on what became a lifelong renovation effort. Within just a few months, she already added more than a dozen rooms and decided to do so despite having no formal training in carpentry, interior design, or construction. The constant renovations ended only upon her death in September of 1922, leaving the home incomplete and her plans unfinished. And despite this, the amount she managed to accomplish within her lifetime was impressive. Thanks to Sarah's efforts, what stands today is a 4-story, 160-room, and 24,000-square-foot mansion. The home has 2,000 doors, 10,000 windows, 47 fireplaces, 17 chimneys, 40 stairways, 40 bedrooms, 2 ballrooms, 13 bathrooms, 6 kitchens, 3 elevators, 2 basements, and a partridge in a pear tree. These rooms are all decked out in cool finishings such as gold and silver chandeliers, hand-inlaid parquet floors, and original stained glass windows. However, this regal home isn't just pretty, it's also rumored to be haunted. This because a medium allegedly told her the ghosts of those killed by the Winchester rifle would haunt her until the day she died, unless she went out west to build a house with room for all of them. Other stories say that she was already being haunted by these ghosts at the family mansion in New Haven. However, after moving out west to California, the ghosts followed her. As a result, she made the home very large and confusing. The hope was that by creating doors leading into blank walls, interior windows, zigzagging hallways, and the stairs leading up to the ceiling, she could outsmart the ghosts that tormented her. There's also been stories of ghosts who haunt the house today. For example, there's apparently a ghost known as Clyde, who's a popular resident at the Winchester estate. Clyde is a man with a mustache, and is usually seen either pushing a wheelbarrow in the basement or trying to repair the fireplace in one of the ballrooms. There was also less obvious paranormal phenomena, such as gentle tugs of shirts or skirts during tours and unexplainable footsteps. Yet, like with many haunted houses, historians have their doubts about whether or not these ghosts are real or just made-up stories. After all, many of Sarah's longtime employees and friends denied the story about the medium both during and after her lifetime, and there are some who believe that the whole paranormal bit promoted by the Winchester Mystery House is just a marketing gimmick. However, the only way to know for sure is to visit the home for yourself. I dare you. Thanks for watching, everyone. I will see you next time. Thank you to our channel members.